Hi there, my name is Dr. Leanna Dudley from Denver Vision Therapy, and I wanted to talk to you today about aniseikonia and how we can correct for it. So this is a topic that has been a specialty of mine for several years, and I think one of the biggest barriers that patients have in treatment is in getting the diagnosis and getting screened for this condition. So I wanted to share with you a little bit about how you can find out if this is an issue that might be affecting you or your patients. So, what is aniseikonia besides being a tricky word to say? Well, it's a size image difference between the two eyes. So, just to kind of reiterate, we have two eyes and they have to point at the same place to allow us to have single vision, something we often take for granted. If it's hard to keep the two images together, if the eyes are pointing in the same place, then we have double vision, which completely derails any productive visual work that you want to do. Driving, reading, everything falls apart. So, double vision is very like one of our worst vision symptoms. Now, what aniseikonia is when the size of the right eye image and the left eye image are slightly different. And we often are looking for one eye that is minified, which will be a smaller image. So this makes it very difficult to keep someone's vision single. So they may or may not have double vision, but they definitely have difficulty keeping those two images together. Now, it doesn't take much of a size difference for this to occur. So, for these two fuzzy characters here, they are only 4.25% difference. And you can probably see the difference if you're looking carefully, but at first glance, you may not even notice the difference. What I want to show you is what happens when we merge these two images together, because it can get really, even though you're not seeing this in a binocular sense, it can be kind of uncomfortable. Look at this image. Does anyone feel that kind of visceral sense that this is something your eyes want to dart away from? Now imagine that this is how your eyes looked all the time. This is how everything looked to you all the time. This kind of shaky image is something else I hear. It's a lot of eye strain and the feeling that the eyes don't want to work together. So, what causes aniseikonia? Well, there's a couple different things that can cause it, but I want to focus on today is a cause that's from retinal pathology. And so this can often be a retinal detachment that has been repaired with surgery, with an air bubble or an oil bubble or anything else that can affect the macula. And what happens is that the photoreceptors at the level of the retina are disrupted and they're in a different place now. They were here and now they're here. And because they're usually more spread out as a result of swelling, but now that's all gone and everything's quiet and stable. But the photoreceptors are in a different spot, which causes the image to appear smaller in the eye that was affected by the retinal procedure. There's another cause for this condition just to be aware of, and that is if there's a difference in prescription between the right and left eyes that's greater than 3 diopters. So 3.0, somewhere around there. If there's a difference, then it does create a size image difference. And typically, the eye that has more plus will be more a magnified image. And that can also cause a lot of discomfort, and it can cause a little difficulty using those glasses. So let's talk about a case where, oh, there's that reading with a double vision and aniseikonia and things moving around. That can be really, really uncomfortable. You can see why someone would not want to read with that. Okay, so let's talk about a case where we have Ivan, and he came in with 1 year post retinal surgery repair. His retina is now stable, so that's good. That's definitely a requirement. He's an engineer and he's very observant about all these details in his vision, and he notices even small changes. So he notices and he tells me up front the size of the image in one eye is different from the other eye, and this is the eye that had the retinal detachment repair. And he did say that it was also distorted, which, sometimes that's something we can't address. But in this case, it was minor. He reported that his vision was uncomfortable. He feels like his eyes are not working together. He feels like he's lost his depth perception. He has difficulty while driving, while reading. I mean, he was really dependent on his vision for his job, and he was quite miserable. Headaches, dizziness, the whole works, basically. Nothing relieved it because this is his full time. This is what he's experiencing all the time. Now, what we do for the testing, move myself here. What we do for the testing, this is a test that I developed in office to be able to measure the amount of Aniseikonia that somebody has. So what the patient does is they put on their red-green glasses over their regular glasses, and they are able to view these half circles, where one eye views one half circle and the other eye views the other half circle because the red and the green cancel. So they're only seeing one half circle with each eye. And then they are then able to tell me, and people can do this with pretty good accuracy, they're able to tell which is bigger and which is smaller. And so if a person without Aniseikonia looked at this test from the get-go, this is his results. This is not the first slide I show them, but they would say, okay, both circles are the same size. So he didn't. He had one that was bigger. And so I made that one smaller or made the other one bigger until both half circles look the same size. And then I can use the program to measure the size of the images. And this showed a 4.25% size image difference between his right and left eyes. So that gave us the numbers that we needed. And then we ordered the glasses for him. You can see here with the black line, that's how much different the right and left eye images are. Just a little bit at the top, a little bit at the bottom, but there is a difference. Now I will talk a little bit about the size lenses here. The size lenses that we use are usually made by Shaw Lens Company. And it's important to kind of have an idea just in case the patients ask, but they are thicker. And that is how they work. They have to be thicker throughout uniformly throughout the lens. And that is what allows that image to be magnified so that it matches the size of the other lens. So for him, we ordered a 4% Shaw lens, and this is not his glasses. I would actually say, and I would recommend this to all patients, that it's best to use a plastic frame that hides the edge thickness. And really, if you use a plastic frame, most of the time you get pretty good results and it's not super obvious. What happened with Ivan was that all of his vision symptoms improved. He no longer had any issues. This fixed everything. He didn't have any eye strain, headaches, double vision. He had no problems driving. His depth perception returned, and he was absolutely thrilled. I mean, he still comes in every year and tells me and thanks me and tells me how much this changed his life. So it was pretty awesome. So how can you find these patients? Because not all of them are as observant as Ivan, where they can tell you that they have image size difference between two eyes. Well, I'd say my biggest complaint that I hear is that they feel like their eyes don't work well together. They might get eye strain, headaches, and dizziness, have poor depth perception like Ivan did, and they might have double vision. I would also say it's best to refer for any double vision because there's no amount of double vision that is normal and okay. So if there's any concerns that patients have about how they're using their vision, that's when optometry can get involved, and specifically somebody who can use a Shaw lens or a size lens to treat that. The other consideration is I do always make sure that their retina is stable. That typically means they are 6 months post-op from any retinal surgeries, and there's no longer any active macular swelling. That has all become quiet. The other concern is that we want to make sure that the patient understands that this is going to be a lifelong thing. It's a big difference, and it's so wonderful that the surgeons are so skilled and talented to be able to save so many of these retinas that we used to not be able to save. And it shows us the difference between eyesight and vision. And eyesight is the information that the eye is able to see and then send to the brain. And of course, this is the first step in seeing. But once that information is sent to the brain, how the brain is able to process it, fuse the images together, and use that information, that's what vision is. And so you can have eyesight that is good, but not have good vision because your brain can't use it and process it. And that's a lot of what we do, is make sure somebody's vision is functioning as well as it can be. So if you have any other questions or want to reach out, our email address for the office here is info@denvervt.com. And you can check out our website for more information. Thank you so much.